about a very important topic of Indian Evidence Act, that is admission and confession. So let's get started. So admission and confession are one of the most important topic when we talk about Indian Evidence Act. I have completed related videos from section 1 to section 16. The link will be provided in the description. If you don't find out that link, go to my channel and see the playlist related to Indian Evidence Act. Well, when we talk about the topic, this topic is very much important and also the complex one. If you ask me about Indian Evidence Act, there are three topics that is the base of Indian Evidence Act. First one is admission and confession, the second one is dying declaration, and the third one is burden of proof. So this video is so much important. I would ask you to share this video to the every person who is related to the law in any manner. Let's start. When we talk about admission and confession, we must look at this chart. You can see the red portion. It is the statement. Let's say the admission is the yellow portion and the blue portion is confession. You can also understand this in this manner: the statement is very wide and the smaller part of the statement is admission and the smaller part of admission is confession. When any accused person admits or accepts any statement, it is admission. When any person confesses the offense, that he has committed that offense, that means a confession. So in this way you can also say that every confession is an admission, but not every admission is confession. So let us first come to admission. There are some of the important sections that you must have to understood in order to better understanding of admission. Section 17 of Indian Evidence Act talks about that admission can be of three types: in oral form, in documentary form, or in electronic form. Oral means anything that has been said, documentary which has been written, and the electronic form includes the email, pen drive, or any other matter that is in the form of electronics. Section 18 talks about that the admission can also be made by any other person on party's behalf. I will take this section in detail in the next slide. Section 21 talks about that the admission can be proved against a person, but there are some of the conditions that has to be fulfilled, that is provided under section 21, that I will also consider in the next slide. And the 31 talks about the evidentiary value of admission, that value, what is the evidentiary value of admission. So it just says that it is not conclusive proof, but it works as a stopple. You must have known conclusive proof, that I have made a video on it in Indian Evidence Act introduction. Estoppel means any promise that you has been made in the past, then you cannot deny when the time came to fulfillment of that promise. Section 18 talk about those person who can give admission on the behalf of the party. The first one is party to the suit and proceedings. Every person who is participated in any suit or in any proceeding, he himself can give an admission, or an admission can also be given by his agent, but it must be expressly and impliedly authorized. Admission can also be given by a person having representative character, and also it can be given by a person who has proprietary or pecuniary interest. Proprietary here means property related, and pecuniary means the money related matter. And the last one is the person from which the party to the proceeding derives its interest. So these are the persons or the party which can give the admission on behalf of the person in the suit or proceeding. Let us come to section 21. It says that admission can be proved against a person. That means a person who is admitting any statement or who is accepting any statement, it can be proved against it. But there are three conditions And once these three conditions has been fulfilled, then only that admission can be proved against him. So first one is the person who is making that statement is dead, which is also known as dying declaration under section 32. Once a person gives a statement and he died, then that statement will be considered as a statement and can also be proved against him. The second condition is that when the statement which has been given shows that there is existence of mind or body, that on which I have made a video and it covers section 14. The third and the last condition is that any situation which is relevant other than as admission made by the person which covers under these three conditions will consider as admission, and it can also be proved against him. Confession can be made to two persons, the police and also to the magistrate. For when we talk about police, there are two sections, section 25 and section 27, which have contrary opinion. Section 25 says that any statement that is made to police has no evidentiary value and cannot be proved against the person. That means a person who is giving a statement to any police officer, that statement cannot be proved against him. But on other hand, section 27 has a contrary opinion that I will discover in the next slide. So let us come to magistrate. Any statement that is made in the presence of magistrate is the confession of the person and can be proved against him. Clearly written here that confession to police and magistrate. Mostly people don't know about police, but you will not see this statement anywhere written in this act, but you can sense the influence of this statement. As section 25 states that the statement to police officer cannot be proved against this person, it totally refuses this contention. And 26 state that the confession in the immediate presence of magistrate is the only confession and can be proved against the person. But here the term comes, it's section 27, the heading is different, but the sense is the same. What I am saying, confession to police, it says that those facts, whether that amount to confession or not, can be proved against the person if the consequence of the information that is received is by the accused in the custody of police. So let us take the example to understand this section. If there is police and the accused give a information to the police about the stolen property that he had hided from the police at certain place. Police reach to that place and find that stolen property. That means the statement what accused has said to the police about the stolen property is the confession, as the police find out the hidden stolen property. So that's all for today's video. If you have related question, you can ask. I know that admission and confession are quite complex and not easy to understand, but you regularly view this video one or two times, you will get to understand the confession and admission in an easy way. The thing that I recommend is to use your Bayer Act, read the sentence clearly, and if you have any question, I am here. Feel free to ask, you can ask anything. I will love to help you. So I will meet you in another video. Till then, goodbye.